at sa ibabaw nitong bato ay itatatag ko ang aking simbahan. At sa kanya'y di mananaig ang kapangyarihan ng impyerno. Ikaw ay Pedro, ikaw ay Pedro, at sa ibabaw nitong bato ay itatatag ko ang aking simbahan.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us celebrate the mystery of Christ's love. Let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. O God, Almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who on the solemnity of the Apostles Peter and Paul give us the noble and holy joy of this day, grant, we pray, that your Church may in all things follow the teaching of those through whom she received the beginnings of right religion, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, King Herod laid hands upon some members of the church to harm them. He had James, the brother of John, killed by the sword. And when he saw this was pleasing to the Jews. He proceeded to arrest Peter also. It was the feast of the unleavened bread. He had him taken into custody and put in prison, under the guard of 4 squads of 4 soldiers each. He intended to bring him before the people after Passover. Peter thus was being kept in prison, but prayer by the church was fervently being made to God on his behalf. On the very night before Herod was to bring him to trial, Peter, secured by double chains, was sleeping between 2 soldiers, while outside the door, guards kept watch on the prison. Suddenly, the angel of the Lord stood by him, and the light shone in the cell. He tapped Peter on the side and awakened him, saying, "Get up quickly." The chains fell from his wrist. The angel said to him, "Put on your belt and your sandals." He did so. Then he said to him, put on your cloak and follow me." So he followed him out, not realizing that what was happening through the angel was real. He thought he was seeing a vision. They passed the first guard, then the second, and came to the iron gate leading out to the city, which opened for them by itself. They emerged and made their way down an alley, and suddenly the angel left him. Then Peter recovered his senses and said, "Now I know for certain that the Lord sent his angel and rescued me from the hand of Herod and from all that the Jewish people were expecting." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever be in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the poor one called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is, and bless the man who takes refuge in him.
The angel of the Lord will rescue those who fear him. A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. I, Paul, I'm already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The Lord stood by me and gave me strength, so that through me the proclamation might be completed and all the Gentiles might hear it. And I was rescued from the lion's mouth, and the Lord will rescue me from every evil threat and will bring me safe to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. And the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Sa araw pong ito, pinagdiriwang po natin ang kapistahan ni San Pedro at ni San Pablo. At maganda rin po na sa simbahang ito bilang isang basilika minor ay pinagdiriwang natin ito sa natatanging pamamaraan at kasama din ng ating pagdiriwang ang ating pananalangin para sa kahalili ni San Pedro, ang Santo Papa, si Papa Francisco. Kaya ho, mamaya pagkatapos po ng ating pagpapahayag ng pananampalataya, ay ipagdarasal natin sama-sama bilang isang sambayan ng Kristiyano ang ating Santo Papa, ang kahalili ni San Pedro. At kung titignan po natin sa ating unang pagbasa, ang unang simbahan ginagawa na ito. Pinapanalangin na nila si San Pedro. Nung binasa ho sa atin kanina, ang ating unang pagbasa, nung si Pedro ho ay dinakip at hinuli, ano ang ginawa ng simbahan? Pinagdasal nila si Pedro. At kung babalikan natin yung unang pagbasa, napakaganda ng pagkakasabi. Peter thus was kept in prison, but prayer by the church was fervently made to God on his behalf. The church prayed for Peter. When Peter was in trouble, sino ang kanyang backer? Sino ang kanyang pwedeng saligan? Ang simbahan na nagdarasal para sa kanya. Kaya maganda rin po, no, bilang Kristiyano, ang patuloy nating pananalangin. At hindi lamang kay Pedro. Hindi ba kapag ikay may problema, ang backer mo din ang simbahan? Eh, di ba, pag may problema ka, sasabihin mo, Father, minsan may lalapit sa akin, Father, pwede pong i-bless niyo po ako at pag-pray. At itatanong ko, oh, bakit? Kasi po, Father, mag-board exam po ako. Oh, padadasal natin. Father, may sakit ako, pwede mo ba akong ipag-pray? Pag minsan may kaibigan ka na alam mong mabait, hindi humapait, ano, mabait. Mabait na kaibigan. Minsan sasabihin mo sa kanya, Mare, pagdasal mo naman ako. Medyo nagkakalabuan na kami ng kumpare mo. Pagdasal mo naman kami. We ask the church to pray for us. Kaya minsan may kaibigan ka, baka meron dito sa inyo. Nung nalaman na naluluwas ka ng Maynila at dadaan ka ng simbahan ng Quiapo, may isang kaibigan sa inyo magsasabi, ay pumunta ka ba ng Quiapo? Pagdasal mo naman ako. Kaya napakaganda po na bilang isang simbahan, hindi lang natin pinagdarasal ang sarili natin, hindi lang natin pinagdarasal yung sarili nating kahilingan, sarili nating pangangailangan, pero pinagdarasal din natin ang bawat isa. We pray for the needs of one another. We pray for each other. Siguro yun po ang napakagandang larawan na ipinakita sa atin ng ating unang pagbasa. Ang simbahan ay pinapanalangin ang bawat isa. Praying for each other. Baka huwi dito, meron dito nagpipilgrimage. Nagtutungo ngayon dito sa simbahan ng Quiapo. Galing pa ho ng probinsya. Magsisimba muna bago ho mag-food trip. Pero ang pinakamahalaga sa lahat, we learn to pray for each other. At ang simbahan din, sa simisang ito, pinagdarasal din ang lahat ng mga pilgrims na nagtutungo sa Quiapo sa araw na ito. Kaya ho ang mga misang ito ay kung kahapon po ay araw ng debosyon, ngayon po ay araw ng mga peregrino na nagtutungo sa Quiapo dahil walang pasok, magdarasal, and the church also will pray for you. May daladalang kahilingan, may daladalang mga intensyon, pinagdarasal tayo ng bawat isang Kristiyano. Sa atin hong ebanghelyo, si Pedro ho, tinanong ni Jesus ang kanyang mga alagad, ano ang sabi nila tungkol sa akin? Kumbaga si Jesus nagtatanong, ano ba ang naririnig ninyo? Ano ba ang nasa asagap ninyong sinasabi nila tungkol sa akin? At sumagot naman yung mga alagad, sabi nila, si Elias ho kayo. Sabi ng iba ho ay kayo si Juan Bautista. Pero naging personal yung tanong ni Jesus sa kanila nung sinabi, e kayo, sino ako para sa inyo? Who do you say that the Son of Man is? From who do they say? Who do people say? Jesus asked the question, who do you say that I am? At ang sagot ni Pedro, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Yung simpleng tanong ni Pedro, ni Jesus, si Pedro ang sumagot at naging pagpapahayag ng kanyang pananampalataya. Kaya magandang imbitasyon din po sa atin bilang mga Kristiyano na huwag tayong mahiya na ipahayag ang ating pananampalataya. Huwag tayo mahiya na maging Kristiyano. Huwag tayo mahiya na maging deboto ni Jesus Nazareno. Huwag tayo mahiya na maging isang alagad ni Jesus. Si Pedro nang tinanong, siya'y ipinahayag niya ang kanyang pananampalataya. Sana tayo din bilang Kristiyano, huwag tayong mahiya na ipahayag ang ating pananampalataya kahit saan. Kahit saan tayo nagpupunta. Dito sa loob ng simbahan, comfortable tayong ipahayag ang ating pananampalataya. Pero sana paglabas ng simbahan, hindi tumitigil ang pagiging Kristiyano natin. Sana paglabas ng simbahan, kahit saan man tayo nagpupunta sa bahay o sa trabaho, hindi tumitigil ang pagiging Kristiyano natin. At kahit doon, ipahayag din natin ang pananampalataya natin. Ito magandang paalala sa atin ng kapistahan ngayon ni San Pedro at ni San Pablo. Dalawang patuloy na nagpahayag ng mabuting balita. Si Pablo na nagpahayag ng mabuting balita sa lahat ng dako, naging masigasig sa kanyang pagpapahayag. Pinakamaraming bansa o lugar na napuntahan. Siguro si Pablo po ang most traveled sa kanila. Pero ang kanyang mga pagpupunta sa ibang lugar ay para ipahayag ang mabuting balita. Kahit saan siya nagpunta, ipinahayag niya ang mabuting balita. At ito po din ang imbitasyon sa atin bilang mga Kristiyano, peregrino at deboto sa araw na ito. Ipahayag si Jesus kahit saan man tayo nagpupunta. Ipanalangin ang bawat isa. Ipanalangin ang Santo Papa. Kung ganun po yung gagawin natin, tayo ay lumalago sa ating pananampalataya kay Jesus Nazareno. Tayo ay lumalago sa ating pagiging Kristiyano. We grow in faith, we grow in love, by professing our faith wherever we go, by praying for one another. Amen.
Please all stand.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. And for our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
God the Father omnipotent, God of the Son of wisdom, God the Holy Spirit of love, we ask you deign to listen to our pledge of loyalty. We are your children, firmly believing in your divinity and eternal providence, redeemed by the blood of the Son, vivified by all-embracing grace of love eternal, and sustained on earth through the powerful intercession of Mary, our Queen and Mother. Hail to you, O God. Hail to you, O Blessed Trinity.
Christus vinci, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
And to you, Peter, the very first mortal, whoever exclaimed with deep faith and trust, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, and to all his successors, we say with conviction and joy, blessed are you, Simon Peter, the rock of the living church.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
To Francis, our Pope, the Vicar of Christ on earth, visible head of the Church, doctor and teacher of all the faithful, guardian of apostolic tradition, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our love.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
To the Supreme Pontiff of the Church, courageous leader of the nations, the very personification of the Spirit of Vatican II, and upholder of the dignity of holy priesthood, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our obedience.
Christus vincit, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
To His Holiness the Pope, tireless defender of the sanctity of the home, of the innate priceless value of human life, and of the dignity of persons, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our hope.
Christus vincit, Christus reina, Christus, Christus impera.
To the visible head of the Christian Church, indomitable teacher, leader and father of all the faithful, steadfast in truth in the midst of errors and misunderstanding, unyielding in courage in the midst of danger, and a most reliable beacon of spiritual light and consolation, to you, Pope Francis, we pledge our undying loyalty and filial veneration now and forever.
Christus vinci, Christus reinat, Christus, Christus impera.
We bring our intentions to the Father with that same faith of the apostles Peter and Paul, with the faith of the fisherman on whom the church is built, and the faith of the teacher of so many nations. In every prayer we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. We bring our intentions to the Father with that same faith of the apostles Peter and Paul, with the faith of the fishermen on whom the church is built, and the faith of the teacher of so many nations. For our Holy Father, successor to Saint Peter, that the Lord may continue to make him a rock on which he can build up the church in our own time, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who work for life, for justice and for peace, that the Lord will give them courage to finish their race and to keep their faith in his divine help for their cause, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations, that willing young hearts may take on the challenge of priestly ministry and the power to bind and loose in Christ's name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries, that the Lord may stand by their side and give them strength, so that through them the proclamation might be completed and all nations may hear the good news, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are held bound, whether by sickness, addiction, or external operation, that will all of us praying fervently on their behalf, God's angel may lead them to freedom and new life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved, whose lives have been poured out like a libation, that they may be purified to receive the crown of righteousness from the Lord, the just judge of all, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God and Father, hear the prayers of this community, gathered in the faith of the apostles, and help us by their intercession. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Gather today in your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy, as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. Lord, we lift up to you all these gifts we offer for your glory. We will eat this living bread, we will drink this saving cup, and feel your presence, O Lord. As we offer this bread, and as we bring you this wine, bless them, Lord Jesus, feed us now, give us life, send us your Spirit, the source of our lives, and together we will serve you with love.
Please all stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the prayer of the apostles, O Lord, accompany the sacrificial gift that we present to your name for consecration, and may their intercession make us devoted to you in celebration of the sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by your providence, the blessed apostles Peter and Paul bring us joy. Peter foremost in confessing the faith. Paul is an outstanding preacher. Peter, who established the early church from the remnant of Israel. Paul, master and teacher of the Gentiles that you call. And so with each in a different way, gathered together the one family of Christ and revered together throughout the world. They share one martyr's crown. And therefore, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, are full of your glory, full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. To all who will receive the Holy Communion, please say Amen when the priest or lay minister is saying Body of Christ, and reverently consume the Body of Christ before leaving at the front of the priest or lay minister. Please be guided accordingly.
Gustate et videte coniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus virgis sperat, qui sperat in eo. To me, all you that labor, all you that labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Gustate et videte coniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus virgis sperat, qui sperat in eo. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory the Lord. The lowly will hear me glad. Gustate et videte coniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus virgis sperat, qui sperat in eo. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol His name. I sought the Lord, and He answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Gustate et videte coniam suavis est Dominus. Beatus virgis sperat, qui sperat in eo.
Announcement. Mabibili pa rin po ang opisyal na imahe ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Paris Finance Office. Mga paalala sa mga nagsisimba, pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana de Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant us, O God, who have been renewed by this sacrament, so to live in the Church that preserving in the breaking of the bread and in the teaching of the apostles, we may be one heart and one soul, made steadfast in your love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your Church in this world from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter his holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in most need of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles, that they may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipintuho ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong kinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, niluwalhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, niluwalhati ka namin.